When you build a website on WordPress, you want at the end of the page maybe to have the availability for people to share that page, share that post, so that you get more visitors. And in order to do that, you're not going to be able to find it on the actual tools to edit a page or edit a template. It's actually hidden under tools, marketing, and share buttons. So I'm going to show you exactly how you do that in this tutorial. And from then on, you'll be able to allow people to share everything, every bit of content you put online. And that's super important because sharing is what will really put you out there. You want people to like what you're putting out there and then share. So that button needs to be at the bottom of your page for sure. So let's go check it out on the computer. There are some details about the settings and what you may or may not want and how you want it. And so we're gonna check it out right now. So we're starting now on my website, miamifinancialcoach.wordpress.com. And as you can see, if I go to a page, let's say the homepage, and I want to add this at the end, I'm gonna come here. And if I do a search for share, it only brings SlideShare. Now, if I go to browse all, I can see everything that's available, the blocks. So I already know there is nothing here. Media, design, widgets. You will not find it here. You can search all you want. It just is not going to be here. So you have to know this. It's not necessarily where you would want to look, but you are not going to find it anywhere in the actual page design or blocks or anything like that. So what you have to do is you have to go back to the root of your website. And if you look here at tools, you go to marketing. And on top here, you have marketing tools, traffic, connections, and this is sharing buttons. That's where it all happens. So you click on sharing buttons, and that's where I have it. So if you look at my website, this is what I currently have. It's at the end of the website, and it allows for people to share the page. So if, let's say, they want to put it on their, like, send it by email, it opens the email, and they can send my page directly here. I'm not going to save that. If they want to create a post on Reddit, it opens Reddit and it creates the post for you. So it's really helpful because it allows people to share your content on any platform you choose. So the way you do this, you go back to sharing buttons and you decide, first of all, where you want it. So show like and sharing buttons on the front page, the archive pages and search results. Yes. On posts, yes. On pages, yes. And on media, yes. You don't have to choose all of them, but you can. Comment likes. Do you want people to be able to comment? Well, I don't really necessarily like for people to make comments on the website, so I chose not to use this, but you can if you want. And if you click on the little eye, it tells you, encourage your community by giving readers the ability to show appreciation for one another's comment. So I'm not interested in that. And you can also use your Twitter username and it will be included in the tweets when people share using the Twitter button. I'm not big on Twitter, so I'm not going to use that either. Save changes, and this has been updated. Now you want your label text to be as you like. So personally, I'm just using the icon, but you can use the icon and the text. You can use text only, or you can use the official button, and that will create this. And I also decided to use the reblog and like, which means anyone on WordPress can reblog, meaning they share your blog into their own blog, and they can also click on like. And another thing is I have already chosen my icons. If I want to edit the sharing buttons, I come here, and currently this is what I have. So press this goes to WordPress, Twitter, Facebook, email, LinkedIn, Reddit, Pinterest, and WhatsApp. If I want people to be able to print, it adds the print, Tumblr, Pocket, Telegram, Mastodon, Nextdoor, and Skype. And I can also reorder them, so I can bring the email on the front here. I can put Twitter here at a little bit later, LinkedIn, Reddit, Pinterest, WhatsApp. I can do print here, remove Skype, Nextdoor, Mastodon, Telegram, Pocket, Tumblr, and I'm going to keep these, and I have changed the order. I'm actually going to reorder and put print and email at the end. And that will work this way. And now I can go here, say save changes. And when I go to the page and refresh the page, you see that it's a little bit different. Also, did you find this article helpful? Share it. This text is saved on the top. Edit label text. This is where you change the text that you want to see. Did you find this article helpful? Share it. This is right here, and you press close. And that's it. Now you have everything you need. And this is really, really good for your website, your web page, your blogs to be retweeted or reshared or placed on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, whatever you think. It's really helping people want to share that information. Thank you so much for visiting Katia's Buzz. I hope this tip was helpful. Please leave me a comment below. Let me know where you are and how you find this helpful or not so helpful, if you're going to be using it, and I'd love to hear from you. Have a beautiful day. I'll see you around. Make sure you press like, subscribe to my channel, and press the little bell so that you get notified on future videos. I'll see you around. Have a beautiful day.